Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about putting keywords in the responses to app reviews. Okay, let me start off by saying something I forget to say on every single video, which is thank you to everybody who subscribed to the channel. If you haven't had a chance to subscribe, please do. Please go ahead and like or dislike the video, depending on your preference. And if you haven't joined our live stream yet, we do our live stream every Friday night at 5 p.m. UK time. So that will be tonight. If you can make it, great. If you have any questions you want to put to the group, that's a perfect opportunity to do that. Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in last week from True Dreams. True Dreams said, "Hey Eric, I have a question. Is it okay to use keywords while replying to reviews? Like if somebody gives you a 5-star or 4-star rating, can we reply to him or her like, thanks for trying this cool arcade game, something like that. Is this fine or do you think Google will ban us if we use relevant keywords while replying?" Now this is something that I had heard last year by an ASO person that I was having a conversation with, and he was saying that was something that they were doing on the iOS side, which was replying to reviews with keywords, and I thought that was fantastic. So this is something that we do. We try to put them in there. We're not so blatant as to do like, thanks for using this cool arcade game or something like that, which I don't think are very good keywords, by the way. I mean, just because they're so saturated, but if you have a better keyword than that. But we do try to put keywords into the responses. I know for a fact that the keywords in reviews are ranked, because I did a video about this about 2 years ago on EarSpy, where I was talking about how we were ranking for keywords, like we were ranking for phrases like, you know, catch a cheating boyfriend, catch a cheating girlfriend, things that were not even in my app, but people were like leaving in the reviews and they were doing things like that. And even the word spy is used so often in the reviews that it still ranks really high, even though we've taken spy out of the title, out of the description, out of everywhere. I mean, we know that it's still working. So that's one way to do it, but I wouldn't be so blatant about it, right? If you could work it into the conversation a little bit more, then that's great. We do try to reply to all reviews because we think that, you know, since Google is making that option available to us, we're going to use everything that Google throws our way. You know, if they want us to use something, we'll use it. But yeah, I think it needs to be relevant. The English has to be good. If you could put those keywords in there a little bit, I think that's okay. I don't know if the replies work as well as the actual reviews. I do know the reviews work. Now, a few years ago, I've had a few consultations with AdMob people where they'll give me some advice. And one of the times they had told me about using keywords in links. So you're gonna have backlinks that go to Google Play, then you wanna put the keywords in the link. So we focus on this a bit early on, where we started trying to put backlinks to our Google Play page as opposed to our own website, so that we could bolster that up in the rankings. And one of the things that the Google representative told me, that rather than put the name of your app in the link, so like EarSpy as a link to the EarSpy page, put, you know, spy app or spy game, whatever it is like that. So that's where you'd want to put that, because that does work too. And this is one of the reasons that, this is one of the ways that Google Play is much different than the App Store, because it does take all of the backlinks, everything into consideration that goes into that. And the advice was a few years old, but I assume it's still the same. I mean, early on, I went on to Fiverr and I was trying to find some backlinks. I was going through those different methods because somebody suggested it to me, and I just hate dealing with SEO people, because it just seems kind of slimy to me. You know, this is the way that they work. I'll just put this link in all these comments of all these blogs and everything like that. So it was something I did. I think I did like one Fiverr job. I think I got 20 backlinks, but we've had other backlinks from other websites, like Gizmodo featured us once, and that really helped. And we saw everything shoot up, and I think that's really helped in terms of the rankings too. So yes, I would say this is just my advice. If any of you guys out there disagree with me, then please let me know. But yes, I would say if you're gonna reply, try to reply with the keywords in the review, but don't do it obvious. You don't stuff the review keywords, because if it does look bad, then they're just gonna stop doing it altogether. You know, it's just, and I don't know how well it would help. I would say if you're going to do it, start measuring it, because that's something I never bother measuring it, that kind of thing. So, but my belief is that the entire Google Play page is part of the PageRank algorithm when it does the rankings. I know that the reviews are, I know that the description is, the title definitely is. So yeah, in terms of the review responses, It's just something that we do to try to get it up the ranking. So yes, I would say yes, do that. If anybody else out there has any different experiences with that, let us know. But my experience has always been, yeah, we might as well. But when I say we might as well, it has to be relevant to the person you're replying to. Like we'll say for our Chinese Mandarin learning app, we'll say, thank you very much for the 5 stars. We really hope this helps you learn Chinese better, right? That makes sense. And it also brings the keywords in there, as opposed to thanks for trying this cool arcade game, because that just sounds a bit spammy to me, but that's just me. So anyway, true dreams, I hope that helps. I hope I see some of you guys tonight at the live stream. That is it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.